Hello everyone. Today we are going to see a new point from microwave spectroscope. And you all have known the concept of the microwave spectroscopy and about the microwave region. So, for the microwave spectroscopy or the rotational spectroscopy, molecules should possess the permanent net dipole moment. For example, SCM. H contains permanent positive charge, chlorine contains permanent negative charge. That's why called as a dipole. So, we have seen the rigid rotor. So, we have considered the HCl molecule, then there is a bond which is very strong and it is unbreakable bond. So, that bond is called as a rigid. So, we have calculated the bond length, that is R, then the moment of inertia, I, and the rotational constant or the spacing between two lines, that is B. So, based on that knowledge, we will continue with our today's lecture, the non-rigid rotator. So, the non-rigid rotator is the rotator in which the bond is breakable. It is not much stronger. So, see here. In practice, spectrum lines are not exactly equidistant. That means when we draw an energy level diagram of a rotational spectrum for the non-rigid rotator, in this case, the lines are not spaced in an equal distance. And the separation between two energy levels is going to decrease when we are going to increase the J value. Means we know the J is the simply rotational quantum number. It is 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on up to the infinity number of energy levels will be there. So simply the J is when increasing, the B value is going to decrease. So there is an inverse relationship between the B and G. Then molecules stretch and become non-rigid with increasing rotation. And you all know there are the electronic energy levels, in between that the vibrational energy levels, inside that rotational energy levels are placed. Means what? When we are going to rotate the molecule, it vibrates 100 times. Okay. So, whenever we are going to rotate the molecule, it will undergo the vibrational motion like the stretching and the compression. So, when the molecule stretched and become non-rigid with increasing rotations. A correction term containing the centrifugal distortion is a capital D and it is called as the centrifugal distortion constant. Because molecule is continuously rotating, so it has a centrifugal force and the centrifugal distortion constant is capital D, and which corrects for the fact the bond is not rigid. Okay. So, here I have written the concepts related to the non-rigid rotator. The separation between the successive lines, that is denoted by B, B is a rotational constant and whose unit is in per centimeter. Okay. And it decreases steadily with increasing the J value. Means simply when we increasing the J value or the rotational energy level number, then simultaneously B is going to decrease or the spacing between two energy levels is going to decrease. And another relation is also given here. When we are increasing J, obviously bond length will be increasing. So B is directly proportional to bond length is directly proportional to J and B is inversely proportional to the J. So, assumption of a rigid bond is only an approximation. In fact, all bonds are elastic to some extent. Okay. All bonds are elastic. They are either compressed or stretched. And the increase in the length with increase in J merely reflects the fact that the more quickly a diatomic molecules rotates, the greater is the centrifugal force tending to move the atoms apart. Means simply when we are increasing J, obviously bond length is going to increase and the molecule rotates with much faster rate and it has a centrifugal force, and due to that the atoms moves apart in case of the non-rigid rotator. So second consequence is given here. There are two consequences I will give first here. So when the bond is elastic, molecule may have vibrational energy, that is the bond will stretch and compress periodically. Okay, as I have told, the when we are going to give one rotation, molecule will vibrate 100 times. That's why the molecule has a vibrational energy. The bond will be either stretched or compressed periodically with a certain fundamental frequency dependent upon the masses of the atoms and the elasticity. So it will be called as a force constant. So if the motion is simple harmonic, the force constant is given by K is equal to 4 pi square omega bar square C square mu. So the molecule has a motion and the bond is either compressing or the stretching. That means bond has a elasticity. So certain kind of force is there, and that force can be given by a force constant capital K, and K is equal to 4 pi square omega bar square C square mu. So here pi is a constant whose value is 3.14. Then omega bar is a new term, that is a vibration frequency, and it is in per centimeters. Then C is a velocity of light and its value is 3×10⁻¹ centimeter per second. Then mu is a reduced mass. As we know, the equation of the reduced mass calculation, that is m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2. So when we take two atoms in a molecule, first atom contains m1 mass, second atom contains m2 mass. From this we can easily calculate the reduced mass mu. Then capital B equation we know very well. That equation is H upon 8 pi square IC. So here H is a Planck's constant whose value is 6.626×10⁻³⁴ joule seconds. And pi is constant again, which is equal to 3.14. I is the moment of inertia, which is equal to mu r squared. And C is the velocity of light. So here new term is included, that is the moment of inertia, and its definition is I is equal to mu r squared. Mu is the reduced mass and r is the bond length. So just put value of I here and rewrite the equation as B is equal to H upon 8 pi square mu r square C. And as we know, B is inversely proportional to the bond length. So B is inversely proportional to 1 upon r square. So from this equation we can get B is equal to 1 upon r square. So simply B is inversely proportional to the 1 upon r square. And when R and B are measured by the microwave techniques in the microwave spectroscopy, many hundreds of vibrations occur during a single rotation, and hence the major value is an average. Okay, because so many vibrations occur there, the molecule is going to stretch and the compress simultaneously. That's why we cannot measure the exact value of the R. So it will be taken in the form of an average value. So we will take the average here. So the average value of 1 upon r square is not equal to 1 upon r e square. So the value of the bond length which we have calculated, that average is not equal to the 1 upon r e square, or we can say that the equilibrium bond length. So before rotating molecule or before vibrating molecule, molecule is at rest. That means it is at the equilibrium, and at that time we have measured the bond length, which is equal to Re. E represents the equilibrium state. So average value taken, which is the 1 upon r square, is not equal to 1 upon Re square. This will be happened. So, consider a bond of equilibrium length 0.1 nanometer. Okay. So, Re is equal to 0.1 nanometer. And the molecule is vibrating between the limits 0.09 and 0.11 nanometer. So, they have given us R1 and R2. So, we have to find out our average. So, by this, we can calculate the R average or mean value of the R, which is equal to 0.09 plus 0.11 divided by 2. After calculating value, we will get R average is equal to 0.1. So, from this, we can see that the given value of the equilibrium bond length is 0.1 nanometer. And the value which we have calculated is 0.1. So, both values are equal. But here we have written one sentence. The average value of 1 upon R square is not equal to the 1 upon R square. Is this is true or not? We will see here. Okay. So, see here, but 1 upon R square. Okay. We know the value of R. R1 and R2. This is value of R1. This is value of R2. So, just take the reciprocals of R1 and R2 and do the square of that term. Okay. So, 1 upon 0.09 bracket square plus 1 upon 0.11 bracket square and whole term divided by 2 is there. Okay. So, from this we will get the value 103.05 nanometer square. Then we want to take the R average from this equation. So, we got 1 upon R square average is equal to 103.05. So, just do rearrangement of this equation. So, after rearrangement, equation will be R average is equal to square root of 1 divided by 103.05. So, when we take the square root of this term, the answer will be this 0.0985 nanometer. So, see, now these two values are equal or not. Here, Re is 0.1 and here R average is different. So, when these two values are not different, then we can say that real vibrations are not simple harmonic. Okay. Since a real bond may be stretched more easily than it may be compressed. So, molecule should undergo stretching than the compression. And that's why that will be not equal. The Re is not equal to R average. And this is really results in R average is always greater than R equilibrium.